The state and county are partnering with Apple to create digital versions of Hawaii driver's licenses and state IDs.
We want to make things as easy and as secure for all of our residents as possible. Since we launched it a couple of days ago, there's been over 14,000 applications for it, and so far over 9,000 has been approved by the city. So it's really exciting.
Real ID compliant credentials can be uploaded in your Apple Wallet by selecting driver's license and state ID and then following the instructions. The process is fairly easy.
During the setup process, you'll also be required to take a selfie to verify your identity.
In all, it took about 5 minutes.
They did a really good job to make sure it's seamless, but if there's additional information they're going to need from you, they may hold off on approving your application until they get more information from you.
You can use the digital ID wherever they have mobile readers, including the Honolulu Airport and at some stores.
At this time, you cannot use it on any other governmental areas. If you're trying to get into the federal building, they're not going to accept your mobile driver's license. If a police officer requests your ID, you cannot use it for that either.
In a statement, the city technology director says it's very early in the deployment of mobile driver's licenses in the U.S. Until there are enough devices to read them, people should always carry their card IDs. The goal eventually is to no longer have to carry a physical ID, but Sniffen says that could take years.
Before we start moving forward on other agencies adopting this, there's going to be additional readers that are necessary, training, and definitely policies that may be in place that may be required. For police officers, there may be even legislation that's necessary for them to be able to accept it.
There are also safety concerns.
The key is, you know, it's Apple. Do you trust Apple? And you know, if you trust them, then it's secure. But with any software, there could be underlying vulnerabilities that we just haven't discovered yet.
Gabriel says if it's compromised, it's similar to your physical ID or driver's license being stolen. Ultimately, technological advances like this are meant to streamline things.